Cambridge Advanced English Speaking Part 2. Example question and two example answers. The examiner will say, here are your photos. I'd like you to compare two of the photos and say what difficulties you believe these people might have faced. Also, how might they be feeling? Remember, only speak about two photos, not all three. If you'd like to test yourself, pause the video now and speak for 60 seconds. Here's an example answer. Important phrases are highlighted in green. If you are doing the exam in person, feel free to point to your photos as you speak about them. Let me speak about these photos. Both of these photos show people who have achieved a goal. The photo with the lone man on a mountain peak, shows us a hiker who has most likely spent a lot of time and physical energy to get to this location. While he's alone, the other photo shows us a group of young graduates together. They surely dedicated a lot of time in order to reach this objective. And so we can see their smiling faces. In contrast, the man on the mountain peak is looking away from the camera, observing the wild landscape in front of him. It can be really hard to get to a graduation. Graduation. You not only have to study and pass many tests, but you have all the struggles and pressure of those formative years to deal with. Those are difficulties all these graduates have overcome. That's why they are clearly beaming with joy. To beam with joy. They're celebrating, whereas the man appears to be in a more quiet, thoughtful mood. Perhaps he's proud that he made it to this point and is taking in the moment quietly. To take in the moment. Let's do that again, but use these two photos. Remember, don't describe the photos, but compare them and answer the questions. I'll choose the photo of the lone man on a mountain peak and of the injured person. Injured person. Both of these pictures show us people in the outdoors. The hiker is in good condition, while the person being helped by paramedics is obviously having problems. The hiker overcame various difficulties to get to this spot on foot. Perhaps he planned this hike a long time ago, and it takes a lot of energy and tired muscles to summit a mountain peak. To arrive to the top of a mountain. Who knows how long the injured person had to wait before help arrived? Not only did he have to overcome more physical pain than the hiker, but he also had to deal with being scared, worried, and cold. I imagine he was swept with a feeling of gratitude when the paramedic showed up. To show up. To arrive. This feeling of thanks and relief is a bit different than the sense of accomplishment the hiker on the mountain peak feels. Accomplishment. Perhaps he's feeling proud of himself, though in front of such a spectacular view. To feel humble. At this point of the exam, the examiner will ask your partner to comment on what you have said. If you want more about the Cambridge exams, check out one of these videos. And remember, communication first, always.